Coming down Second Avenue, we see Evelyn on the left. Before she notices us, a voice calls her name. She turns to see flames outside the deli on Kingsley Street on the sunny pavement, making eyes at her, and I sense a bit of history flickering between them. From her body language, her unspoken thought would seem to be, "You wish, don't you, flames?" "Hi, flames," she breezes. "And I can see your memory of your very first meeting, when you knew that he saw you as wild, free, and self-sufficient, walking with a sway through the beauty of the night, like a part of the night itself, a sweet, sexy woman whom he passed at a corner. The second time he saw you, you were parked in your van, with the door open, staring through the windscreen in thought. On your pale brown skin, a simple golden band necklace hung and flashed in the sunlight. And when you saw him watching you from some way away, you knew what he was thinking. Oh, girl, he was thinking, how beautiful you are. You smiled through the windscreen and touched your golden band. He saw you as embodying how lovingness and warmth could exist in a natural and instinctive form, whatever kind of place it found itself. And when he looked in your eyes, then he felt plugged into a warm electric fountain of rich brown light.